The Las Cruces Public Schools had a grant for gardens in the classroom. We thought about it and decided that doing hydroponics would be the best way to go. Wouldn't have to worry about weather conditions, whether school was in or out of session, because everything is on a timer. The equipment was two totes that were black so that the algae doesn't form. The school maintenance people, they actually built a framework to fasten the light fixtures to. And in the light fixtures, we are using LED tube lighting as opposed to fluorescent tubes. It's cooler and it uses less electricity.
To see the collaboration between NMSU, the district, and our in-house welders, the collaboration between all that just to help students, it was wonderful to see. It was really wonderful.
The first step was just learning the vocabulary. You know, what does hydroponic mean and what do we need for plants to grow and what do plants normally get from the soil that it's not going to be in the water and what do we have to replace?
How do we pollinate hydroponic plants? And some of them said, but you have to have the particular kind of plant that pollinates itself. So what is that called? And so we were even going back to the science program, what do we call those? I don't have all the answers and I never tell the kids I know everything because I'm learning as they are. What kind of tomatoes are we using? They're the same tomatoes that Heinz uses to make their ketchup. So that was a big hook for them.
The kids are enthused about the program. The kids get to taste the fruits of their labors and they sort of get to be in charge. And it's fun. They love it. And they problem solve and it's sort of they're the little master gardeners and, you know, they set it up and they do things and they test things and, you know, sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't.
I know, it's extremely
need more water?
No. We rotate clean water, clean fertilizer. And if we are troubleshooting, then that's when we find out what's going on. So today, we had to get rid of some plants that weren't doing very well. So we checked the pH level last month, and we thought we were on the right track. So the troubleshooting, what happened? That query of interesting mindfulness and process of saying, well, if that didn't work, what's the next step? What do we do?
We had grown lettuce before, and then they switched to all tomatoes, and then they said they wanted to grow strawberries. We have some new strawberry plants from the store. So they're rinsing the soil off, they're getting the fertilizer in the water, pH testing the water, and then recording that because we have a student taking care of the pH level for her final. We took out our old tomatoes. They had to figure out how to get the cups off them and get the rocks out because they'll take those home and plant those. And then getting the strawberries put back in the water, getting the bubblers set back up.
Recycling is a big thing. We talk about seeds. Well, I ran out of seeds. I'm not going to plant anything? No. We take that fruit. We take what came off the vine and we get those seeds out of there and then we can plant for next year.
Why are they brown? There's just so many different elements of middle school you can bring in to this. And, you know, from math to science to reading to research, they've been doing research projects on it. But it gets them excited about growing gardens themselves. It gets them excited about trying food.
And the whole idea of seed to table, that conception in itself, we can bring up ideas of what did you eat yesterday? Did you know that came from the ground? Did you know that came from a seed? That concept and then they make that connection is wonderful because now they know, hey, that just doesn't come from the store or a wrapper. I can actually grow that and make that.
They all need to learn varying degrees of where your food comes from. And does it taste any different from what's grown in the dirt to what's grown in fortified water? And we really hope that this continues. And I believe the school system is very interested that it would do so.